All right. Welcome back, everybody. Sports Chat 503. Thank you guys very much for watching. First time, long time. Either way, I appreciate it. Coming to you live from Portland. No, wait. We're at the coast. We are out here. We're doing it. We're doing it live out here. Watching this game. We're almost at halftime here. We're going to see what we can do here in a second. I'm just getting everything right here. Okay. Mick3R says, not a big believer, huh? All right. Well, they're in this game. 18-13 halftime score. 13 seconds to go here. It's a 3rd and 9. And we'll see where we go from here, okay? I think this is pretty much what we're going to be doing here just for a little bit here. Got myself the halftime entertainment. You know, out here at the coast, not in Lubbock. Got a pretty nice view here. I do wish I was with the flock out in Lubbock. So cheers to everybody who made it out there. But I kind of like doing the halftime show a little bit. It might bleed into the third quarter just a little bit. You know, we'll ride with it. But I can do a live stream right after the game as well. So I'm going to do two of them. So if you're here now and you got 14 people in here right now and you want to join me after the game, then we got stuff to talk about. Let's do it. But right now, these guys got to get a stop here. It's 18-13, 13 seconds left in second quarter. I tried to time it up as best I could. TV takes a little bit longer though to guesstimate. Let's see what they can do here. Put some pressure on them. That's Shuck getting out of it. Dang. These guys are going to make a game out of this. You know, I hate to say the last team that scores wins, or the last team that has the ball wins. That's a lot how it goes out here. A lot of times when you get in these shootouts, you know, you expect the best team to win over time. Most of the time, but sometimes you never know. And I really respect Texas Tech. I think Texas Tech's got a lot going on for it, but yeah, got to clean up the penalties. I'm seeing some of the chat here real quick. Let's go through the chat. Shepherd Ducks. Tosh does not know how to know a QB spy. Okay, yeah, the QB spy is tough. You know, Shuck's big run in the first half, you know, we knew that was coming. We you know, if you're a Duck fan and you spend any time watching Tyler Shuck, he can go. He can scoot, man. So, okay, let's see what we can do here. We got 3 seconds left. It's a second down. They called that incomplete. Oh, I thought that was a catch. Joe Duck says, clean up the penalties. Yep, you're right. Penalties get cleaned up. You're A-okay. Yo. I like that. Yo. Yo is saying the Ducks are playing like an unranked team. Well, that kind of stuff happens sometimes on the road, you know? You're still up, you know, they kick this field goal here. You're still up two. You know, I like the going for it, the two-point conversion. I still don't really know how it happened. They really didn't do a good job of covering it. It was like me at the sidelines after a few IPA. Okay, here we go. Let's see if we can put some pressure on this. This isn't even a gimme here. This is deep. And looks like it was no good. I like that. Let's go. I like that. Shepherd Ducks in here. How did they get a penalty and we get a sack and first down? Yeah. Well, you know, the weird things happen out here, Shep. Weird things happen, my man. I love that picture of Iwo Jima, though. Big fan of that stuff. You know, I history teacher over here, so that plays well over here. Well, all right. I don't have a lot of stats and statistics for you up front, nor do I really care because I think numbers are kind of interesting. But I think numbers can tell whatever truth you want it to. You know, my first instinct on the first half of this game was, it's pretty much what I thought it was going to happen, because I actually expected this team to really show up. I thought that Texas Tech was going to, come back after that loss and really show somebody something. They're opening their stadium. They're going to fly around. The big bomb to Franklin was awesome. They're just showing the highlights right now. You know, Oregon's offense looked good when it looked good, but it also looked really stale at times. Love the pass to Tez. I think that's the play you're going to want to run to Tez over and over and over and make somebody stop that. He's open in space across the Bo's face. It's an easy throw. It doesn't take that long to run that route, and you obviously see great results. That he got a touchdown there. He got a touchdown on that basically the same exact play in the spring game. And so, you know, I think you just got to – in a game like this, you're on the road. You're in a hostile environment. You know, they always say 3 points to the road team. I think this is more worth 7. I think it's a stronger road environment, as I do think Autzen is as well. But I really liked there was some pressure on the quarterback with Shuck. Shuck's elusive. And, you know, anybody who has been a fan, like I said, anybody who's been a fan here with the Ducks for all these years knows how good of a quarterback Tyler is, man. He's a really good quarterback. He's a strong quarterback. He can move the ball with the feet. He can throw the ball. He's real steady. He doesn't get rattled. Yeah, he'll make the wrong play sometimes. A lot of quarterbacks do. But he is a guy who I think can really go get you a play when you need it. And he's proven that over and over and over during his time at Oregon. And I think he'll continue to prove that over and over and over in his time at Texas Tech. I know that there's been some, you know, issues with him, maybe with turning the ball over at times. And, you know, the ball does get a little loose with him. And that was a great play on the ball. Jamal Hill with that tackle I thought was awesome. Perfectly formed tackle. Popped the ball loose. And to be able to get that, is a great deal. You got to do something with it. And I think the Ducks have missed opportunities a little bit. And you got to cash in on every single opportunity on the road. So we got Dan Lanning in here, though. Coach is a big fan of Sports Chat 503. Jumps in at halftime. Thanks so much, Coach. Appreciate you. I know you got to get back to the guys. You just got to check in with us real quick. Second half team. Coach has got us covered. So thank you so much on that. And second half team. I really do think that when you look at the running game looks solid, right? And so I think that's always where I always look first as a former offensive lineman, as a guy who kind of focused on that side of the ball. I want to see, can you run the ball? Because if you can run the ball, I think you can establish whatever you want to do outside of that. You're not trying to force the ball, throwing the ball, if you can run the ball. And I do think they can run the ball, and I think they're going to have success on it. They just got bit by these penalties. You know, like they said, you got to clean the penalties up early. One of the comments early was you got to clean those penalties up, and obviously Coach would agree on that one. Hey, Dion's in here. Love it. So, you know, thanks so much, Coach Sanders, for joining us here on Sports Chat 503 as well, because obviously Coach Sanders is the talk of the town right now. For him to give a little bit of his time to us is tremendous. So congratulations, Coach, on a big win against Nebraska, big home opener. And take care of business next week, and we'll see you at Autzen. Can't wait for that opener, and hopefully – you'll have a lot of respect at that opener. Hopefully the Ducks do a good job of respecting the bus, because I know that that game sold out, and I know that the Duck fans are really excited for that one. So thanks so much, Coach, for joining us. Steven's in here. He does not like something, but still laughed at it. Okay. I like that. Hazmat's in here. I like that. You know, Hazmat's a classic old school Sports Chat, a contributor. Is that the right word? Is that for a thing what we're doing? I don't even know. Is this a podcast? I just think it's a live stream. I know I'm on YouTube. I think a podcast is something that it goes on like Spotify or Apple or something. Okay. Let's get us. What else we got here? Okay. Yeah, Joe Duck, pretty clean, right? Yeah, exactly. You know, Connerly, again, one of my favorite players on the whole team. Love him and his dad, his whole family representing. But young guy, he's going to make some mistakes here and there. Going to get caught a little bit. Marcus Harper as well got caught a little bit. And offensive linemen are going to hold. That's going to happen. So I don't worry about offensive linemen holding. But, you know, it is a tough penalty, especially when it takes a touchdown back and everybody's eyes are on you. Nobody likes that. Nobody likes that. So what else we got in the chat here? What's going on? Okay, what's going on? All Trust is in here. Can we spy Shuck for the love of God? All Trust. Yeah, Shuck's elusive, man. Like I said, I think he's a type of quarterback that can really get you. He's a unique guy because I think that he wants to stay in the pocket. But, you know, that design run was such a beautiful thing. It was a nice little delay. He waited for it. His little stutter step in the middle of the lane there before he exploded through. Again, I think that he's a really seasoned guy. You know, these extra year COVID guys have got a lot going on for him. They've taken a lot of snaps. They've played a lot of football. So I think it's going to be a hell of an entertaining second half. Can't wait for it. So, you know, the Texas Tech folk, you know, I think they're really pumped up. They want this game. This is going to be a huge game. If Texas Tech gets this win, that would be an absolutely amazing way for them to start the year. Losing to Wyoming in week one and coming back and beating Oregon in week two. Unreal. So, no, I think Oregon's going to put it together. I think Oregon's going to be just kind of one step ahead of them the whole second half. And I don't expect a blowout. Early on, I was expecting, when I went on RC's show, I was kind of forced to make a pick. And I think I picked like a 45-42 type of game. And I thought it was going to be a little more offense than defense. But I knew that they were going to score the ball, and I knew that Oregon was going to score the ball. It was just about, you know, who was going to be able to stop somebody. And I do think that Oregon's defense has to tighten up, and it's an important concept. You got to spy the quarterback. Everybody knows that, especially these days. So, okay. And we got to talk a little bit about the rest of the country right now. Bama is down. Of course, I'm not watching that closely, but Bama's down to Texas. That would be a heck of a storyline. Obviously, Colorado winning against Nebraska. I think it's a little overstated because I think Nebraska's not that great, but it is what it is. Old Duck fan says penalties are killing the Ducks. Yeah, you clean up those penalties. You play a smarter second half, and you're right in the middle of where you want to be. All you need to really have in this one is about a two-score advantage, you know, whether that's a hello, whether that's, you know, whatever it is, you know, field goals or touchdowns or whatever. Got a live stream here. It's a halftime thing. So,
oh, are the Ducks playing?
Ducks are playing. We're up right now against Texas Tech.
Oh.
Yeah, we're up. We're up. So, we're 18 to 13.
Oh, wow.
I think. Or 18 to 15, something like that. Yeah. Either way, we're good. We're good. Thanks so much. Enjoy the sunset tonight. All right. So, yeah. Birch, Mateo both playing beautifully. Let's see here. Miss face mask. Yeah. Oh, Herbert. Herbert.
After Justin.
Yep. Yep. All right. Have a great one. All right. So I got the people coming up here saying hello. Love that. The Utes. Yeah. The Ute game was crazy. What a game for the Utes. And golly, I mean, they pulled that one out. That was awesome for them. Yeah, I'm super excited for them. Yeah, 18-13. Thank you, old Duck fan. I knew it was right in there. After Justin. Yeah, you heard my wife say it. Yeah, we named our dog Herbert. He was the same. He's a COVID baby dog, so he was in the same, you know, area where, you know, Herbert was a rookie year and coming off the Rose Bowl and all that sort of stuff when we got him. The dog was also born in Eugene, so. Washington State. Let's go. So, yeah, man, things are good right now. Things are good in the Pac-12 has got things going on. Here we are dying on the vine. Oh, man. Yeah, Nick Does Future says, same draft class. Yeah, he was the puppy of the year. He is a good puppy, man, I'll tell you what. Buddy. Yeah, so Washington State, yeah, is up right now 17-6 against Wisconsin. I love that. We got to talk about all these different scores going through. Your scoreboard update. North Carolina with a 2-overtime win against App State. Wow, I did not see that one coming. That's crazy. Yeah, Texas up on Bama. I don't know if Bama fans wanted to see that. Can't wait to watch Paul Feinbaum show after that one. Yeah, Planet Moolah says SEC looks weak. I agree with this. I think the SEC looks weak most of the time outside of the top tier teams, and yet they get the whole thing. They get the whole enchilada every year. They get whatever they want on a platter. Oh, Lord. Let's see what else we got going here. Top 25. Let's see our Pac-12. Let's go through the Pac-12 real quick here. We got Oregon. We talked about us. We got Oregon. We got Washington State. Arizona losing to Mississippi State. Ouch. 14-0 against Arizona. That hurts. Going into halftime there. UCLA up on San Diego State, but not by much. We talked about Utah with the game of the day. I guess Colorado could take a little bit of that shine just because Colorado now, I mean, they're getting game day coming to the thing. I mean, who's going to go to game day? Colorado State. Now Colorado State's going to mop the floor with Colorado's going to mop the floor with Colorado State. They just want to be there for a primetime win and get all the sound bites for the rest of the year. Because I'm telling you, dude, he rolls in there like a combination of James Brown, Ric Flair. I mean, this dude comes in there with all the one-liners. He's got it. You didn't make me. You can't break me. I mean, dude, come on now. Come on now. I mean, you go to church with that guy in a press conference. USC tonight with Stanford, stoked for that one. Oregon State, they're going to obviously do their thing. Washington, Tulsa, that's a good win for the Dogs. So there you go. There's your update. Golly, I missed my calling of being an update guy. All right, Warren Forens, I like the pressure on the QB. Yeah, I do. Except for the fact that you just know, Warren, you just know that Tyler's going to break a couple. You got to give it up to the guys. And Tyler's going to break a couple. You know that's going to be happening. Hazmat says, cheers. I'm making pizza. You're making pizza while the halftime's going, listening to sports chat. You're a freaking legend. Cheers to you. Let's freaking go. Hazmat. I love that, dude. Okay. What else we got here? Hazmat says, Ryan's just chilling at the beach. Yep. I'm at the compound. It's a little like the Kennedy compound, except for it's about maybe 1/100th of the size. I'm lucky to have what our family has, but it's the same house that my grandfather built basically in the 60s. We keep it up, though. Look at Mikey G in the building. My guy. What do you think of this? What do you think of this first half? What are your thoughts on this first half? What do we do in the second half? What comes out in the second half here? I'll ride with y'all for a little bit. I'll ride with you in the third quarter for a little bit. I don't know if I can take it. If it gets too tight in the fourth quarter, I might have to bail so I can do my push-ups in peace. To chill out. Okay. Oh, this NC State game went right down to the wire. They had to kick a field goal in OT to win it. Oh, they missed. And oh, that was to win the game. Oh, wow. Wow. Oh, and then they got another opportunity. Missed that one too. Kickers, man. Kickers. I love that Peyton Manning one where he's like, I'm winning the MVP and we're here talking about an idiot kicker. Yeah, dude, the refs are accepting their home team payments at halftime. I think they get that up front. Or is it like a contractor? You pay like up front and then you pay the rest at the end. Restraining order. Oh, Planet Moolah. We have not gotten in there. We can do that in the post game. Because that probably has some pretty deep thoughts on that one. I mean, it's wild, obviously. They're going to try to do whatever they can do to survive. I don't know if that's the right play. Yeah, the refs are Pac-12. Yeah, I mean, dude, they cannot make a call on the field to save their life. Yeah, no, I totally agree. They always have to go to the damn review. Sam Jetson here saying, Patrick with the dime that you went. I still have not really seen a clear review of that. Highlight. I got to see a replay. Because on my version of the TV or whatever, it felt like they cut away from it and they were showing the lineman when he was, I don't know what the hell was going on. I don't know. It's beer 30. What up? Yeah, I mean, I didn't really drink much beer in the first half. I kind of cracked this one right before we were going live here. But Washington State putting on a little bit of a show. 17-6. I like. Jeff says, I'm always Pac-12, but I'm having a hard time pulling for Colorado. I love that. That's fine. I mean, you know, I think it's an acquired taste, or I think it's a unique kind of willingness to engage in a unique opportunity is kind of how I look at it. I think this is kind of an experiment that I think is going well so far. So I think you just got to ride with it while it's going well. And then hopefully the wheels don't completely fall off of it down the stretch here. But it is what it is, man. Sam Jet is giving me the play-by-play here. Patrick was falling, got hit, threw off his back foot to T. Ferg on the money for the two-pointer. It could be the play of the game because it could decide this thing. It could be that close. This game could be that close. So, yeah, man, I think it's all about the run game here. Sin, what do we got? We got Sin and JT. We got this one here. Need to get that run game. The drop passes hurt everybody because, you know, it's about a rhythm thing, right? So it's about establishing a rhythm where you can go run, pass, pass, run, pass, pass, whatever your cadence you want it to be. But it throws off that rhythm to see that ball just drop. Stops the clock, stops your momentum, come back to the line of scrimmage, talking about why it didn't work, thinking about negative thoughts, go back to the line of scrimmage. Guys want to pass protect for like maybe a play or two, but they want to get back to run blocking. So then it feels like then you know you're going to come back with a run play, but now the defense also knows you're going to come back with a run play. They send extra guys, makes it harder to run. So it's like it one drop play can impact the next like 2 to 3, 4 plays in a series because of the play calling. It upsets the balance of the whole thing, man. And it's frustrating. Not only that, it's just frustrating. And you don't want to play frustrated. You want to play light and bouncy and flying around, man. We have considerable speed, but it's not like stretching the field. Yeah, I can see that. And the big run gashers, some of them have been called back with the holding plays, right? So, you know, you can get it. I think any Pac-12 team will make it through the season. I don't see anybody going undefeated because I just think the conference is too difficult. So, I think there's just too many good teams. But I think the Ducks right now with Texas Tech, I think they're playing okay. I think that Texas Tech is better than a lot of people are giving them credit for. That first game, they should have gone out there and just beat Wyoming. If they would have played the second and third quarter the way they played the first quarter, they would have won by 40 points, 30 points. It would have been no problem. But they got caught up in a little bit of a web. They got into Wyoming's game a little bit, and it kind of all just slowed down, went to molasses, and the game really was decided at the very end of the game and in overtime. You know, most of the game from Tech point of view was kind of taken away from them in the middle part of the game. So this is a game where they wanted to control the clock. They wanted to take advantage of these opportunities. They did. They got Oregon to kick first. They got to defer. So they're going to get the ball here in the second half. They got Oregon to punt in that first series, which was tremendous. And then Now they've got an opportunity here coming out in the second half to go do something. Now that everybody's cooled off a little bit, the field's cooled off a little bit, coming to be a more of a nighttime environment here in the second half, I think the better teams are going to show up. I think the first half was a little hot, and it definitely was hot on the Ducks sideline. So that can add something too. Again, I think that, you know, just environment, we talk about crowd environment, talking also about a heat environment is something else, but I think the running game for Oregon needs to just show up. And if the Oregon game running game shows up, everything else takes care of business, because the linemen want to run block. That's like a part of football in all levels. So let's run the ball, and they've proven they can run the ball. Noah looks pretty good, but Bucky is the guy, dude. I think Bucky looks really good. So how is throwing ideas on the field? It's not okay. And they don't even allow it. It's contraband there. They don't want, the university doesn't want anything really to do with it. It just was a tradition that's been done there by the fans. It's pretty wild. The guy who I had on here earlier, RC Maxfield, we broke it down here for a little while. It was really wild to see it. And they might pop it off right here too with the second half. People go find their more tortillas, or they didn't throw them in the first half. They waited for them. They saved them for the second half. I don't know. Yeah, Nick does futures. What's up with the tortillas? The tortilla thing was because somebody said that the only thing that was going on in Texas or in Lubbock was Texas Tech football and a tortilla factory. And so they took offense to that. And so they started throwing tortillas. And yeah. I mean, everybody has their own thing, right? False starts. Yeah, crowd noise is big there. Crowd noise is big there. And, you know, you the way it works with the offensive line is, you know, oftentimes, you know, you're going off of a variety of different signals or cadences or timed release or whatever the case may be. They do a bunch of different stuff. But when you're on the road and it's all silent count, you know, sometimes it falls apart a little bit. Second half is starting right here. Shuck with a big play. They throw a flag again. Looks like it was an interception. I'm just going to roll through the second half just a little bit. I'm just going to play maybe 5 minutes in here. Looks like we've got a pass interference on the defense. So not a great start to the second half. You get a wide receiver pretty well wide open. That was the play? That was the penalty? No, couldn't have been. Well, you almost had a late hit on the quarterback as well. So, man, oh, man. These flags are killing them. All right. Oregon starting the second half right where they ended off the first half, which is with a penalty and giving up some yardage here. That's not a good play at all. Wow. Got to get that guy to the ground. That's a good 25-yard gainer, 30-yard gainer, 40-yard maybe even. Holy moly. He just kept going. Youch, that hurts. That's not the way you want to start if you're an Oregon defense. And then you got Tyler on the run. Okay. Okay. I mean, again, I think there's a bunch of stuff going on here. Yeah, Sam says another flag. Yeah, Boss, you know, I think the linebacker is going to be tested in this second half. It's going to be interesting. But, yeah, like I'm saying, I'm going to ride out here maybe a minute or two here. We've got we're at 29 minutes. I'll ride out here. But I'm going to do a live stream after the game. So if you want to jump in here after the game, hit it up. Oh, that looks to be an interesting play. Jamal Hill looks pretty solid this game. Steven. That's hilarious. Steven says, loving these halftime adjustments. When will I start doing the push-ups? Yeah, push-ups, dude. I got to take out some of this nervous energy, man. Oh, God. Wide open. And can't tackle. Down to the five. Son of a bitch. Well, you knew this was going to happen. Oh, just completely out of position. At every step of the way, the defense was out of position. All right, well, it looks like they're going to go down there and get a nice little tutty to start their second half. It's just about whether the Ducks can answer here. The Ducks are going to be really forced to answer here. So let's go through. We'll ride this out here in just a second, and then I'll let you guys go. We'll all watch it here with the Ducks ball here. Oh, that's a touchdown right there for Tyler. Get in the end zone, Tyler Shuck. Ouch. Ouch. Okay, y'all. I'm going to bounce out of here, and I'll switch it over here after the game. Come back in if you want to jump back in here and chat in the post game. Let me know. Let's go, Ducks. Okay, I'll talk to you guys soon after the game. Enjoy.